Welcome to the lecture on building materials. In today's lecture, we will learn about steam. In previous lecture, we have learned about pig iron as well as about cast iron and the wrought iron. We have learned that the ferrous material is divided into the three categories, that is the cast iron, then the wrought iron, and the last one is steel. We have learned already about this, that the ferrous material is can be divided into three categories, that is cast iron, wrought iron, and the steel. Why? The pig iron is one of the material which is required for the production of these three. So the steel we obtained the steel from the pig iron. Right? Generally, the material what we get from the pig iron is the carbon content. If the carbon content is in between 2% to 4%, then generally it is classified as the cast iron. While if this carbon content is in between 0.15% to 1.5%, then it is considered as steel. So if the carbon content is in between 0.15 to 1.5%, this will be classified as the steel. Here we can further classify the steel on the basis of this carbon content. The steel can be further classified on the basis of the carbon content. So we will see the different types of the steel. What are the types of the steel? The steel can be classified on the basis of carbon content. We have already learned there. So on the basis of carbon content, we can classify the steel into three types. What are those? First one is mild steel. Second one, hard steel. Third one, tow steel. This mild steel is also known as the low carbon steel. This hard steel is also known as medium carbon steel, while this tow steel, this is known as the high carbon steel. So as we are saying, the steel can be classified on the basis of carbon content. That is only we are saying here, the low carbon steel, that is nothing but the mild steel, the medium carbon steel, that is nothing but the hard steel, and the high carbon steel, that is nothing but the tow steel. So what will be the carbon percentage in this, or so to say the carbon content in the mild steel? The carbon content, it used to be in between 0.15% to 0.25%. the carbon content in the mild-steel, it used to be in between 0.15% to 0.25%, while in the hard-steel or the medium carbon steel, this carbon content, it used to be in between 0.25% to 0.70%, while in this high carbon steel, the carbon content used to be in between 0.7% to 1.50%. So this is the carbon content. On the basis of this carbon content, the steel can be classified to these three categories like this. We'll see next manufacturing of steel. Manufacturing of steel. Generally, the steel we have seven processes by which we can manufacture the steel. We'll list all one by one. One is the basic work process, then we have the open hearth process, then the calcination process, then we have the crucible process, then we have the duplex process, or we can have the triplex process also. One is the ending process, and the last one is the electric process. There are some of the types of some of the method or some of the processes by which we can manufacture the steel. So we will learn and one by one. Let's see the first. Calcination process. What we'll do in this process? First of all, the pig iron is brought into the purest form of wrought iron. The whatever pig iron is available to us, which we will use as a pressing material for the construction of for the production of the steel, that pig iron will be brought first of all in the purest form of wrought iron, so that later on the carbon content can be adjusted accordingly. And so what we are doing in this method, first of all the pig iron is brought into the purest form of wrought iron. Why? So that later on we can adjust the carbon content accordingly, so that we can get the desired degree of this steel. So this is what we will do first of all. Then round shaft calcinated furnace. Or to say a calcinated converter. This prefer here, what will this? A dome shaft calcinated converter is used for making this steel. Then, as we have converted this pin iron to the coolest form of wrought iron, the bar of the wrought iron and the charcoal which will fill in alternate layers. So here this, the bar of wrought iron and the charcoal, it will be filled into the furnace or it will be filled into the converter in the alternate layers. Then suppose if this is the bar of wrought iron, then there will be one layer of charcoal and another layer of the wrought iron bars, then one layer of charcoal powder and again one layer of the wrought iron bar, then again one layer of the charcoal powder, so that the bar of wrought iron and charcoal, it will be filled in the alternate layers in the furnace, or to say in the converter. Then it will be heated for a duration of 5 to 15 days. Right. So that once we have filled the furnace with this, it will be heated for a duration of 5 to 15 days. After its heating, it will be converted to the molten mass. During this process, the charcoal, we have filled the furnace with the alternate layers of the bar of wrought iron and the charcoal. So during this heating process, when it will be converted into the molten mass, the carbon from the charcoal will combine with this molten mass of wrought iron bar. During this, the carbon content charcoal will combine with the molten mass. Fine. So during this, after solidification, we will get the steel, and this steel is particularly known as the blister steel. This particular steel is known as the blister steel. This is what, how we get the steel using this calcination process. Then here next is crucible process. This particular method is used only to get the hard steels. We adopt this method for the production of the hard steel. In this, a converter is used. What? Fine clay crucible is used as a converter. In this, a fine clay crucible material is used as a converter. What will happen here? The bar of wrought iron crucible will remain almost same. bar of what iron, it will be mixed with the charcoal, what we were doing in the previous, the same thing. The bar of wrought iron, it will be mixed with the charcoal and it will be heated in this converter. So that after heating, the carbon will be mixed with the molten wrought iron and hence we will get like this steel after solidification. So after solidification we will get the steel by this method. The steel what we are getting is the hard steel, and where we can use this steel, we can use it for the surgical instrument. For making the surgical instrument we can use this steel, or for making the files. For this, the whatever steel we are getting from this crucible process can be used for these purposes.
Electric furnace.
it will be treated further in electric furnace. So this is what? The duplex process. figure represents an electric furnace. Here, this is a vessel which is made up of the steel plate. We will write the point. First of all, it requires electricity. As we are saying that electric process, it requires electricity for melting the charge. Fine. Other than that, it has the electrodes. It has the electrodes. These electrodes are connected to the vessel. The electric arc is provided into these electrodes. The electric arc is provided into the electrodes, which generates the heat. That generates the heat and it helps in melting the charge. In fact, so then as we are saying that this is a vessel which is made up of the steel plate, which is made up of steel plate. It has a tiltable facility. This vessel has also a tiltable facility. It can tilt like this. So once the charge will be melted, it will tilt and it can be taken into the proper mold, and after solidification we can get the proper steel. Here we have provided these electrodes. These electrodes are connected to this vessel, so that electric arc will be provided into this, which will generate the heat, and the heat will help in melting the charge. This is the, here we have the gate. This gate is known as the charging door, from where we can charge the furnace, and this is the opening door, from where we can get the molten mass after melting it. Fine. Here, this electric furnace cannot be used for manufacturing at the fuse level. This cannot be used for manufacturing at fuse level. It cannot be used because the capacity of this furnace is very less. Capacity is up to 15 ton only. So it cannot be used as a fuse level. It can be used at a small level only, or a certain type of steel is required, certain degree or certain grade of steel is required, and for the manufacturing of those kind of steel we can use this electric process, because it's very small. If the furnace is very small, so it cannot be used for production at a very large level. Its capacity is up to 15 ton only, but it has certain advantages. That's why we prefer this method over the other. What are those? A certain advantages, that is no formation of ash as well as smoke, no formation. It has the temperature control. It is a quick process. Then the slack amount of slack formed is very less. To do these things, generally we prefer this electric process over the other for the manufacturing of steel. And the uses of steel, where we can use this steel. is used, steel can be used at so many uses or properties. It can be used as a steel member, as a tensile member, construction of RCC, as well as so many vessels. Steel can be used for manufacture of weight and some other things also. That is not at all. We will discuss the properties of the steel one by one. What are the properties? First of all, it is highly elastic. It is high ductile. Then it has good what? It has good tensile strength. Then it has good the compressive strength. Shearing strength, right? It can be hardened. It can be hardened by tempering method. It is also one point. It is highly elastic, highly ductile. Has good tensile strength, good compressive strength. The good shearing strength, it can be hardened by tempering. Then it can be forced. It can be easily riveted. Then it can be easily bent. Then it has good plasticity. As well as it has good conductivity also. So it has so many properties. What are those? Highly elastic, it is ductile, it has good tensile strength, compressive strength and shearing strength. It can be hardened by tempering, it can be forged, it can be riveted, it can be wet at all. It has good plasticity as well as it has good conductivity also. So these are the some of the properties of steel. So we have learned about what is steel, how we get what is steel, how we get this steel, from where we get it, the manufacturing process, different manufacturing process, and as well as we have learned the properties of steel also. Thank you.